everybody. Good morning, good evening. Yeah, it's morning over here. It is about 10 o'clock in the morning, and I just dropped my daughter off to tennis, and I don't know, I was on the drive on the way to the tennis camp. I was came up on a topic, and I don't know, I felt like chatting, and as you see, I've already done my makeup. Had to be quite quick with it. Yeah, I don't know. My topic, or what I was thinking about, was what it means to be a nice girl. Yes, nice girl. How many nice girls do we have out there? Well, I am considered a nice person. And I don't think that's a bad thing. I think a lot of people look at it as, oh my gosh, you're a nice person. You're kind of weak. But I don't know. I really believe that, yeah, you, how can I explain it? Being nice, I like to be nice to people. I like to do things for people. I feel good about it. I love to uplift people, and and if I can be there and to help somebody out, I'm there. And for a lot of other people, you know, when they sometimes people take advantage of that, you know, if they think that you're nice, they oftentimes see you as being somebody who's weak. I don't think it's that you're weak. It's just that, I don't know, nice people, sometimes they get crapped on. But you don't have to get crapped on. You can put an end to that. You can stop that. You can, you know, the moment you detect that, okay, this person might not, you know, this person might not treat me like I'm treating them, pull back. You know, I give people several chances. I mean, because I believe that nobody's perfect and we all make mistakes, and we have our days and stuff. But I like to give people chances, but, you know, I will only give them but so many chances. When I see that, okay, this relationship feels lopsided, you know, then I pull back. And I suggest you do the same, you know. Don't let people, you know, push you in this corner that you're a nice person, and because you're a nice person that you deserve to be crapped on. No, you don't deserve to be crapped on. But you definitely deserve, you deserve that niceness is reciprocated, you know. I don't believe in a tit for a tat either, because I think it's stupid. If you do something nice, or you want to be nice, or I don't know, don't expect anything in return. I mean, but don't also, you know, like I said, have your limits, you know. Don't let people take advantage of you. And that's real important, because I believe there are a lot of people out there who are generally nice. And another thing, if somebody treats you like crap, or is mean to you, don't carry that grudge in you. You know, sometimes we think, okay, I've been hurt, so I'm going to hurt somebody else because I've been hurt, or I'm going to put a block up. Just stay yourself, be you, and just realize, you know, if somebody crapped on us, because you allowed them to in that aspect. I think we're all responsible on, you know, how we let people treat us. You know, I'm a true believer. You have to teach people on how you want to be treated. First off is, how do you treat yourself? Do you treat yourself nice? You know, are you good to yourself? Because if you're not good to yourself, then other people aren't going to be good to you. But if you're, you know, you're treating yourself nice, you take time out for you, and yeah, you spoil yourself and always trying to enhance it. That's a good thing, and people see that, you know. And unfortunately, you do have those people who just like, I'm just gonna try my luck, you know. I'm gonna see if I can use her or whatever. No, put your limits up, and you know, I say I usually give people three strikes. Some people don't even make it to three strikes because if they're so obvious that they're like crappy person and it's just all focused on, you know, themselves, and you know, then I cut it off immediately. You know, I really take distance. But three chances, three strikes and you're out, you know, because otherwise it just, yeah, it evolves into a really dysfunctional relationship. And I think you have enough pressures in the world and you have enough problems with dealing with people, and you don't want to have, you know, people who are supposedly your friends treating you like crap or I don't know, whomever. So continue being a nice person. Do things that make you feel good, but also, like I said, know the limits, you know. Know where to set the boundaries. Know when you're like, okay, no, I'm not gonna do that. You know, for me, if I see that I'm the only person who's giving, or if I'm the only one who's always listening and letting people dump on me, and then when I try to share my stuff, or when I, you know, ask for things, and you know, I don't see it coming back, I get rid of that person. I mean, literally, I really pull back. You know, before I used to be, I won't say I was a person that I let people come and crap, but I just felt like I want to be there for people. I want to help them out. And, you know, I'm sure it's going to come back eventually. No, it doesn't come back. Once somebody thinks that they can use you and you know, be mean or whatever, then they're going to continue to do it, and they'll never change. So the only person who's going to change, who has to change, is you. And you have to change your way of thinking and not let people run over you. And yeah, say mean things. You have to, yeah, love yourself. And and like I said, I think it's good if you're a nice person. We need more nice people in the world. I think we start off as nice people, and unfortunately the world kind of molds us into this hard clay. You know, a lot of people become hard. Some people still stay soft, but others harden up, you know, and it's because of their experience. Yeah, sometimes the closest people, the people that you love, sometimes crap on you, you know. I don't know. I've had people who hurt me, and I just learned to put people in different categories, you know. Stay you. Don't change because of, you know, what society says about nice people, or maybe because somebody hurt you. You know, unfortunately, maybe somebody hurt you, but there's going to be somebody out there who's just like you and who's just as good and happy and will listen to you. And, you know, it will be reciprocated. Really, you're going to find that person. So don't change. If you're a nice person, stay a nice person. You know, but like I said, just set your boundaries. I know I did. I really had to. I'm still learning it, you know. But it took me to the point where I was just like, you know, I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm not going to be somebody's toilet. You know, I heard this saying one time. This guy was like, you know, people are like trash, you know, trashmen. They go around and they collect their trash the whole week, and then they need a dumpster, a place to dump out the trash. And don't let that don't let that person be you. Don't let, you know, don't become that dumpster where people just let out all their crap. No, that's not cool. You know, I understand we all have crappy days and weeks or whatever, or maybe even a month or even a year, but it can't be always, you know. You can't always be the person who's just like, okay, listening, you know, and then, you know, when you have a problem, because we all have issues and we all have problems. It can't be that when you start to share yourself or when you ask for things or people to do things for you and they have an lame excuse or, you know, like I said, it's lopsided. Cut it. Just cut it. Cut it. Cut it. Cut it. Don't waste your time, because actually, you know, by you wasting your time with this person, you might miss your chance and meeting a really cool person that, you know, yeah, who respects you and who's going to give it back, and it's balance. And those are the people that you need in your life, you know. And, you know, like I said, continue being nice. It's nothing wrong with being a nice girl. I like being a nice girl. I like smiling, and I get a joy out of lifting people up. I really do. It's so crazy. I don't know. When I was younger, I was kind of different. I think I was focused more on me. And then as I got older and I started to see, man, it feels good. You know, I like to walk around with a smile and not with a frown, even if I'm in a crappy mood. I mean, okay, I have my days where I'm in a crappy mood, but I still try to smile. And sometimes, you know, I'll be driving and I'm like feeling all good and stuff, and then I have an idiot driver who just butts in front of me and doesn't even say thank you or throws up his hands to say excuse me, and then I'm just like, the next person I'm not gonna let in, and you know, next time I'm gonna just focus on me and I'm just gonna drive and I don't care, you know, I'm just gonna be mean. But it doesn't bring anything. It just makes you feel miserable, you know. I don't know, and I think maybe that's the problem of today's world. That's probably why we have so many narcissist folks, because, or mean people out there, because maybe at one point they were vulnerable or they opened themselves up and somebody came in and just crapped all over them, took advantage of them and whatever, and then they just, since then, they had this attitude, I'm going to stay mean. I'm going to be mean. I'm not going to let nobody get to me. I'm going to be a rock, you know, but being a rock is lonely, you know. It sucks, you know. So if you're a nice person, stay nice, stay who you are, and don't change. And you're not a weak person. Trust me, you're not a weak person. You're just a good person. And consider yourself as very rare, because, you know, there aren't that many good people out there. And so if you are a nice person, keep that reputation and don't be afraid to say you are a nice person, but you are a nice person who sets boundaries. Okay. So I don't know. I had that on my mind. I was driving and yeah, it's a beautiful day. So look, it's a beautiful day. Oh, these people are doing horseback riding. Can you see that? I don't know. Yes, so I don't know. I had that on my mind and I really wanted to share that. And yeah, so thank you for taking the time out and listening to what I have to say. I really do appreciate it, and I appreciate the comments. And if you like this video, like it, you know. I'm still new at this YouTube stuff, so I don't know, but I feel good. I'm excited. I feel like I want to make a video all the time, because I have so much to share and so much to say. And I'm so sure that there are people who feel like or think the same way as I do. And I don't know. Anywho, guys, have a wonderful day or evening or afternoon, wherever you are in the world. And talk to you soon. Bye.